Flashy Flash vs Metal Bat, two of the strongest S-Class heroes. This was never a conversation until Metal Bat's latest performance with Garou against Sage Centipede. This has led many fans to wonder, did Metal Bat's huge pump really made him surpass the likes of Flashy Flash and put him in the conversation of the high tier of the S-Class heroes? And could he really defeat him if they ever decided to fight? But before we answer this, please don't forget to subscribe and hit the notification bell. As many of you forget, this always serves as a reminder. In addition to that, I want to say thank you to all those who supported me and made me reach 4K subscribers. I'm in a huge awe and I'll always be grateful. Again, thank you. Metal Bat is an S-Class hero rank 15. He's one of the heroes who performed really well in the early days of the association that led to the creation of the S-Class category. He was being capable of easily defeating demons. His first showing was against Melsgard, a dragon level monster, was shown being capable of reacting to him alongside the other heroes, and also is the first one who has discovered Melsgard's weakness using his amazing dynamic vision, and this led to the heroes eventually defeating the monster. Metal Bat is also known for his fighting spirit ability, aka resonance, that allows him to get stronger the more he takes damage, as shown against two demon level monsters and later on the hero hunter Garou. However, that doesn't mean Metal Bat can take infinite amount of damage and suddenly would be at the same level or higher than his opponent. There's obviously a limit of how much he can take, and his fight against Garou was evidence of that. This ability was compared to how the monsterization works. When Girogiro was explaining the concept to Garou, he immediately thought of Metal Bat. His best feats before the Monster Association arc is overpowering two demon level monsters and later engaging in a fight against a cadre named Elder Centipede. Although it wasn't really a fight and there was no way Metal Bat at that point would have a chance of beating him, he was still capable of taking hits from him and also managed to discover his weak points, alongside with getting sent flying by him and casually walks it off. Metal Bat also was capable of tanking multiple hits from Garou, who was using Water Stream Rock Smashing Fist. These kind of hits brought a fellow S-Class hero named Tanktop Master on his knees and made Garou surprised, and commented on how Metal Bat is still standing despite losing blood and having several broken bones. But we know that's thanks to his fighting spirit, and this somehow is related to his anger. As the data book stated, after reaching his maximum anger, his striking power would increase to infinity. Metal Bat also nearly lands a blow on Garou before Garou can even react in time, but was stopped by his sister. Murata himself said that Garou would have died if Metal Bat landed that final strike. He after goes to join the heroes in their fight against the cadre and was shown being capable of taking hits from Black S, same kind of hits that destroyed Atomic Samurai. After that, he managed to destroy them easily. Alright, so all of this pales in comparison to what Metal Bat has done from this point on, kinda teaming up with Garou to fight Sage Centipede in order to save the people who were in that helicopter. At first, he was shown to be fast enough to block the centipede's attack, but then he couldn't hang enough as he was brutally punched by Sage Centipede. However, that led to the activation of his fighting spirit, or to be precise, resonance, that resulted into increasing his power and speed immensely that now he can damage him, when a minute ago he couldn't. He goes after to synchronize and coordinate attacks with Garou to legit damage Sage Centipede. Mind you, this is the same Garou who fairly defeated Platinum S and Flashy Flash, and it was stated that the reason they were capable of combining their moves is due to the similarity of the nature of their attack. This resulted into Garou boosting Metal Bat's explosive destructiveness to the point of cracking the centipede's exoskeleton by himself. However, he finally gets defeated and incapacitated by the monster. I want you guys to understand that Sage Centipede is one of the most durable monsters we have seen, and Metal Bat having strength and explosive power to damage him by himself is actually crazy, and it's such a huge feat that shouldn't be overlooked. I've already briefly spoke about Flashy Flash in my first video on this channel, but I'll go ahead and explain more of what he can do. Flashy Flash is known for his outstanding speed. He's the best example of why ranks does not reflect the strength of a hero, capable of literally blitzing any demon level threats before they can even think, and considered to be the first and one of the only heroes who was able to kill two confirmed dragon level threats by himself. His best attribute is not only speed, but also his durability and strength. He was shown being capable of hurting two dragon level monsters without using his sword, and engaging in a three-way fight with Garou using his God Slayer Fist and Platinum S monstrous strength. In addition to that, he was durable enough to take multiple hits from Gale Wind and Fire Flame, and later on against Garou and Platinum S. First, he tanks a barrage of hits from Platinum S and literally brush it off Madara style. and then he holds his own without his sword against two of the most powerful beings in the One Punch Man verse. But his best attribute is obviously speed. He can move so fast that monsters alongside with the explosions they created were appearing still when Flashy Flash got a bit serious, and later on creating countless trails of light that appeared simultaneously between these three powerhouses. This comes as a no surprise since Flashy Flash himself was confirmed to be faster than light, alongside with the fact that Saitama himself commended Flashy Flash's speed by saying, "You're kinda fast." And Saitama rarely commends anyone. It should also be noted that Platinum S said that Flashy Flash is weakened without his sword, and they should take care of him first. And ninjas somehow are stronger with the sword, as evidenced with Sonic being confident of killing the Deep Sea King with it, despite the fact that he couldn't do anything to him before. I don't know if you guys noticed, but despite Garou punching Platinum S when he suggested they should take care of Flashy Flash first, in the next chapter, 154, Platinum S and Garou never engaged till they defeated Flashy Flash. So that plan was kinda still in motion. And later on, Flashy Flash was still conscious after experiencing Cosmic Fear Garou's radiation for a far greater period of time than the vast majority of the heroes around him. Alright, so we know there is absolutely no way of Metal Bat to defeat Flashy Flash from the get-go, as Flashy Flash would literally bliss him and legit take his hat off before he can even react. As we know, he couldn't land a single hit on early Garou, so there is absolutely no way he could react to Flashy Flash, let alone fight him. And I would say he also wouldn't be able to activate his fighting spirit against Flashy, as it was stated in the data book that underestimation, derision, and arrogance are the three behaviors that would seal one's fate when confronting Metal Bat. And judging by Flashy Flash's history of how he deals with monsters, his name is not associated with these three behaviors. So in conclusion, this is not close. Not even a bit. Now, what about Flashy Flash versus already pumped up Metal Bat? Well, it's without a doubt that Metal Bat now is in the conversation of the strongest S-class heroes when he's pumped up. However, I still cannot see him deal with Flashy Flash's speed. But some of you would say, hold on Yasin, wasn't Metal Bat relative to Garou who is faster than Flashy Flash by coordinating his attacks with him?
Right, yeah, of course.
This is clearly unreasonable analysis, and I would say that's due to recency bias. People tend to overlook the simplest facts and details. There's a huge distinction between the two fights, and as Phoenix Man has stated, matchups really matters in One Punch Man verse. And this is important since Garou didn't really need to go all out when it comes to speed against Sage Centipede. You don't really need speed in order to deal with a huge opponent like that who has a very hard time to move in the first place. And to further help the case, the humans in the helicopter alongside with the heroes were seeing and reacting to Metal Bat and, to be precise, Garou multiple times. But prior to that, it was specifically stated that reports claimed it was a paranormal phenomenon and had no idea that it's actually the trajectories of the free-for-all fight between Flashy Flash, Garou, and Platinum S. So in other words, Garou needed to go all out when it comes to speed due to the matchup that he has in front of him, which is against two speedsters. But he doesn't really need to do that against Sage Centipede. Moreover, Metal Bat before even the buff was capable of moving at somehow similar speed to Garou. So does that mean he is as fast as him without being pumped up? Even if Metal Bat somehow was relative to Garou, it's still not Garou going as fast as he could. This is like saying Flashy Flash was operating at the same level of speed as Saitama when they killed those monsters. In other words, Metal Bat isn't nearly as fast as Flashy Flash, and due to recency bias, people were putting Bat at the same level as Garou, which is really crazy to be honest. Even though it was stated that the only reason they were capable of coordinating their attacks is because of the similarity of their moves, and not them being actually relative to each other. The author specifically said there is still a difference in strength. But what about the other factors? When it comes to destructive explosiveness, Metal Bat obviously got that, since he was capable of cracking one of the most durable monsters in the series only with Garou's coordination. And that's not due to his fighting style, by the way. It's literally a combination between amplification and resonance, so in other words, it's not something he could have done by himself at the time. But we know if the fight continues to drag on and he gets more damage that wouldn't knock him out, he will reach that stage by his own. So to sum it up, both Flashy Flash and Metal Bat could hurt each other. However, Flashy Flash still wins, and I would say this is not close, since he is way too superior when it comes to speed and has fatal blows that would completely murder Metal Bat before his resonance would allow him to get stronger. This is not Platinum S versus Orochi, where even though Platinum is extremely fast, Orochi is extremely durable and holds Metal's outstanding regen abilities and healing factor that would be difficult for Platinum to handle. But in this case, Metal Bat's durability would not be able to keep up with the damage and the attacks Flashy Flash would throw at him in such higher speed, and eventually Metal Bat would collapse the same way he did when he got hit by Sage Centipede. So to end this video, I want to say that Metal Bat is definitely one of the strongest in the S-class heroes when he's pumped up, and could more than likely surpass them by time. But he gets extremely overhyped by the vast majority after seeing him fight with Garou, and people act as if he's on the same level as him. So it's safe to say the unsecured ninja wins against the unofficial JoJo character. To the point of cracking the centipede's exoskeleton by himself. I don't know if I said that right. Is this how you say the word? To the point of cracking the centipede's exoskeleton by himself.